I shall sink you a sop. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Honestly, it's a shame you killed the beast. Now we shall abandon all morality whatsoever.
Move it. Hey there. Slower. Come on. Scholars pitched camp here. Should look around. They were scholars. Should have guessed the passages inside were blocked for a reason. Good thing they didn't try to go in there without a Witcher. Of power. magic barrier. Got a bad feeling, damn it. Better. Satchel looks like it belonged to a witcher. inside Vesemir's request. Interesting. Two bad things ended here for this wolf. Not many of us left alive. Seems they were running for the exit. A Witcher brought the ceiling down to bury his foes, ended up burying himself too.
Go, go. Not so fast, Roach. Giddy up. Come on, Roach.
Slow now. Whoa.
Give me a drink!
Run, Roach!
It swallowed Phil and whole.
Oh, there, sir. I'd guess those swords on your back aren't there as festoons. Maybe you could help me.
Maybe. Depends.
Well, there's a cave that, to my mind, would be splendid for aging wine. Not over dry and none too moist.
But?
Well, damn thing's full of noise. The arse-clenching sort. Clinkety, bangety, knockety kind. Sent McClarkin to sea, been 2 days, and he's not back. I reckon it's ought to do with the Elven ruins. Blah. That about the cave. So, lend us a hand, will you?
Fine. I'll have a look in the cave, see what lurks there.
What's up, Kitty Ice? With the beast beat down, the bells should be particularly eager to please.
How do you like that silver?
Thank you.
tie one on last night, too.
Is it over? Is it done? All clear now. Did you manage it?
Yeah, all taken care of.
Ha! And four core witches, layabouts and freeloaders? Bollocks!
Storehouse will be ready in 2 days at most. And here on in, you've cut rate prices on all my goods.
Not from around here, are you?
Nay, from Povis we are. Wandered south for the climb afore the first war. Chills up north were giving me wifey lumbago.
What you got on offer? Wouldn't mind a glance. So long.
Drink! Give me a drink!
I was in the middle of a round of Gwent with...
Slow now.
And I had drawn such good cards.
Not so fast, Roach. Hey-ya!
So what did it be, Dandruff Ditlick? Oh! The whole of us, at once!
You'll never learn. heavy wheels. A merchant's wagon.
Let's go! Go, go!
Move it!
Damn. Something's seriously wrong here.
Come on.
Leave me alone! Leave me alone!
Move it! Let's go. Slow now. Whoa.
Thank you.
Faster. Go.
Do you get for all that work? A crook in your back once you're on in years.
Hey there.
What do you think I'm coming down with a fever?
A crook in your back once you're on in years.
Don't crowd around.
Hey-ya!
Keep calm! Start no brawls!
Those scars. That gaze. Oh, I shivered just looking at him.
Be gone from my sight.
I wager you must beat the maiden's back with a look.
Oh, Witcher, greetings. Kind of you to come. Matilda and I, we've a surprise for you.
You two seem to be getting along.
We are. There came a point we realized we had no grounds to quarrel. Things became altogether pleasant.
And a bit spicy.
Romantic. Quite.
Got it. Needn't say more. Glad things are going well for you. What's the surprise? Some new monster I need to kill?
No. Something far more pleasant.
We've produced a wine. According to the best sommeliers, it might just dethrone Est.
We owe this success to you. So, if you'd agree...
We'd like to name it after you.
What shall we call it?
Why not White Wolf?
Wild, with character. It fits perfectly.
If you wouldn't mind, we'd like to send a few bottles to your home every so often.
I'd be honored. Thanks.
No, we thank you. Take care, Witcher.
Lovely. Them and Matilda. What a story!
have your chit-chat with someone else.
How is it that Duquesa does not feed him as well?
Keep calm! Start no brawls!
The Dutch is small, but do you know any who's not heard of our wines?
You know Master Liam made Matilda. Something tells me it's not...
I do not know how I will ever repay you, Witcher.
Don't expect to be paid. Hope you're feeling better, that's all.
Oh, yes, I feel my strength returning thanks chiefly to Barnabas Basil's care.
Horrible ordeal you endured. Glad I cut it short.
Yes. Years of suffering. You know what was worse than the hunger? Watching my loved ones, my children grow old and die. All my family's long gone now. The last of my kin perished decades past. I fear I've nowhere to go.
This is a big house, big estate. You can stay here.
Truly? I could never infringe so on your hospitality. Yet...
Yeah?
After all I've suffered, the years of starvation, I've but one dream. At last to prepare food that fortifies. Nourishes, to delight in the tastes and smells of spices, to sit at one table with others and eat.
Don't see a problem if that's your dream. You could help Barnabas Basil in the kitchen. Eating his meals, you know he's not a culinary virtuoso.
Nothing could make me happier. Thank you.
No, thank you. House could use a woman's touch.
I've one other thing I'd like to tell you. Many years ago, my father assembled valuables for my diary. I never wed, so they remained unclaimed. These baubles are no use to me now, but to you, well, perhaps let them be a token of my gratitude. If you wish to find them, you must go to my old home, to Trastamara. The dowry lies hidden in a barrel in the cellar. There are several barrels. You must give each a knock until you find the right one.
Do just that. Thanks. You sure you don't feel lonely out here?
I cannot say yet. Too little time has passed since you freed me of my thrall. But somehow, for now at least, I do not feel drawn to the city, to others.
Visited others' homes as a wight?
Yes. But ever at night, when all were asleep, I went in search of spoons.
Remember, you can always change your mind. Decide you've lived here long enough, just say the word.
I'd never wish to seem ungrateful.
And I'd never want you to stay against your will. I'd never expect someone with your past to feel drawn to the kitchen.
Do you fear I will cook in your home as I brewed as a wight?
Counting on you having slightly better taste as a human.
Of that, you can be sure. I loved cooking. Even as a child, my gran was a true master in the kitchen. Her spit-roasted oaks was famed throughout the land.
Thought you were a lady, owned an estate.
Do you mean to say a woman of my rank should have had a cook? You're right, of course. And I had the best of cooks. But I devised the dishes myself. They only prepared them.
See you later.
Take care, Witcher. And remember, you always have warm food awaiting your return.
Around some. Full. Strange. That's awful pretty. It'll look great in the house.
Let's go.
Can you bend?
The jaw-dropping Van Combe awaits a challenger. His tongue as devastating as his fists. His riposte brings grown men to tears. Witcher, do you wish to jump in?
Considering it.
So you're not surprised. Consider this as well. Here, intellect counts as much as strength.
You see, Mancombe is no ordinary fighter.
Mancombe? First I've ever encountered that name.
One should never judge an opponent by his name. Master Mancombe is a saddler, though a valiant one at that. His blows are as fierce as his ripostes are sharp.
Fine, let's start.
Oh, my knees quake like a carnival rattle.
Let's get on with this ridiculous battle.
I'm a top taunter, the best around. Not one to be beaten by some inbred hound.
Guess you'd know, since your mom's a bitch.
Ah, pathetic. This'll be easy. What's wrong? Afraid? Gut feeling queasy?
Your bones look thin, your breathing's wheezy. Afraid one punch might kill you, it's got me uneasy. Fancy insults, not my thing. No other more effective means.
Though a man of few words and even fewer jests, the Witcher is ever a fighter. Geralt has vanquished Mancombe. Two more champions to defeat before you can challenge the Maestro. Still Waters is to be found in Oatville, not far from Mountbank Alley, while Colossus fights in the largest courtyard in San Sebastian.
Sir Frosty Locks, was it you who won the tournament?
Ickritol.
You seek someone?
My warmest greetings.
How goes it, friend?
Oh, it illy hate. come here. Be nimble.
Let's charge! Take him for a ride!
Let's dance!
Geralt! So content to see you. Le Papillon Troubadour. Remember?
Hey there.
I've never found the opportune moment. See, I never had a chance, in fact, to say I'm a devoted fan.
Thanks.
Of Master Dandelion. I know the bards, every ballad in his cycle about the Witcher. Oh, I cannot believe my luck.
Need something from me?
Indeed. A matter most magnificent. My coiffeur, Jean-Louis Lothavik, has gone missing. Now, you shall rescue him while I compose an epic ballad about it. Listen, fair folk, to a glorious tale of a missing friseur and a witterhood prevail.
What happened exactly? Claim the hairdresser's missing, but are you sure?
Yes, yes. I've no doubt something's transpired. Something terrible, absurd. Jean-Louis is never late to work. He's punctual to a fault. I'm certain he'd be honored if I am the one to sing of his dramatic rescue.
Fine, see what I can learn. Now, if you have to come with me, just one request. Stay out of the way. Mine and my swords.
Of course. You shan't even notice me. Jean-Louis' studio is just there. Right here.
What's the matter?
I've hit upon the perfect ending. And all for the glory of her grace, the Duchess.
Thought this was about a witcher and a coiffeur. What's the Duchess got to do with it?
Her grace can be as fickle as the colt she rides. Today, all remember my fine couplets at the tourney. Yet tomorrow, her illustriousness bought by her breakfast might demand a new epic poem. One must grab at opportunity before it flits away.
Well then, where shall we start?
At the door, by breaking it down.
Let's charge!
Pay me no heed!
Take him for a ride!
Pretend I'm not.
Oh, now let's not do anything rash. No. Right, what's going on here?
Scissors are completely dull.
Let's go inside.
No way you could use these to cut hair. Empty pomade jar. Strong floral fragrance.
Any signs?
Very strong.
Dried blood. Knives flecked with flesh.
This jar is empty, too.
We need more.
The prisons are all wrong.
Locks untouched. No attempt at forced entry. The coiffeur's log. A manicure, curling, Cintrian pendulum, Rivian ponytail, raftsman's do. Long out of style in Novigrad. His appointments. Last one was a certain Lady La Pompadour. Know her?
Yes, a dear old bird. Jean-Louis done her hair for a decade. Completely harmless.
Sketch here. Looks like a map. This mean anything to you?
I may understand where it points. But if so, there's not there. Just fields and meadows.
Think I understand.
As do I. Perhaps. Around he looked, yet all was quite proper. I see razors, pomades, but no blasted hair chopper.
Mind being quiet for a minute. Think I might know what happened to the hairdresser. No evidence of a break-in, no signs of a struggle. To my mind, he just went out to find ingredients for his pomade. Looks like he ran out of pomade.
Yes, indeed. He'd have gone into the meadows beyond the city to gather flower petals for it. Trolls must have devoured him. Or a cyclops. Splendid either way.
Think you could find the place using his map?
Naturally.
Lead the way then.
Get shone in its azure glow, scent marking times like a daisical flow.
That's Toussaint in a nutshell.
Take him for a ride!
Slow now,
let's not do anything rash. Slow now.
I knew I lived once. He stole my horse.
Something's in the wind.
They ventured beyond walls by vines entwined, into the unknown the poor barber to find.
Gonna do that the whole way?
Bidding them farewell, the gravestones must covered, they strode briskly on by doubts unencumbered. Behold the location from the map.
Damn it, get back!
Save me, Witcher!
What beast was that?
An archospore.
Might there be more nearby?
Who knows?
And your sharpened senses, what do they say?
That you'd rather turn and run.
Oh, a primo jest. Let us continue onward. I know you'll stand in my defense. You will you not? Onto the witcher's blade flash juices spouted and poured, covering all about in an archospore's gore. No piece of the stylist fell from its bowels. The frizzer had been nabbed by aught else most foul. A beautiful day for a tourney. Hail, fellow. Well met. There! Jean-Louis Pasquet! I'd recognize it anywhere. He was here. We can be certain now.
A basket of flower petals. Same smell as the pomade. Grass is trampled. Multiple sets of footprints. A little blood. Seems you were right. He ran into trouble.
Phew! What luck! I just hope it's not Cyclopes. Hard-pressed to find a rhyme for that. So? On his trail yet, are you?
And all for the glory of her grace, the Duchess.
Made of rock. Trail's gone cold. Wandered deeper into the cave.
My, a talk so dark as to prod one to fear.
Fear uninspiring. No rhymes at the ready.
In some bomb-botched cove here. We're in Nilfgaard, you bung-munch!
What did he do to you?
What did he do? He quaffed me, gave me a duck's ass, an ape drape, a beaver bottle. I don't even know. So ashamed I couldn't attend the tourney. I'd have proved my valor, Mademoiselle Vivian de Tabri my prize. Then this scallywag with his talk of the rage... missed my chance by the hair on my head.
Got him back good from what I can see.
That is but the start. I've not yet decided if I shouldn't snip off something more.
Doesn't seem terribly chivalrous. What about honor? Your oath on the peacock? All that?
I do vow on the noble bird I shall gut you if you do not skedaddle. On guard! Stand and fight! I challenge thee! And you boys dare not intervene! By golly, by gum, this will be chivalrous!
Listen, children, a story you shall hear of a witcher who walloped a rogue knight's steady hair.
I'll spoon out your entrails, then do the same to the half-handed head!
It's grown rather late. I believe we'll be on our way.
Le Papillon, let me hold his wounds. You saved me at the last second.
You're welcome. Jean-Louis Ludovic, I presume. Let's get out of here before he...
Quiet, both of you! I've got it!
They froze in their fear, the knight's henchmen and squires, while his bowels set loose, heaven would spiraled. The witcher cleft him in two lacerated, his neck swing the swine adroitly castrated. With one more caress from the witcher's blade, the knight's guts popped out, his breakfast betrayed. They hobbled apace on his stump arms like crutches, all for the glory of her grace. the Duchess.
Bravo. Almost believed you were there.
Doesn't it seem so? At last, Master Dandelion has a worthy competitor.
What about my pay?
I've decided you should receive a reasonable share of the royalties. Payable, let us say, semi-annually.
Meaning you're broke just now.
I owe you 1,000 thanks, Master Witcher. I'll gladly pay your reward. Not to mention trimming you when you see the need that come by.
Thanks. Take care now.
Go, go.
Come on now.
Giddy up. Whoa there, Roach. Let's go.